In this video, I'll be explaining anatomy of deltoid muscle. Deltoid is part of shoulder joint muscle. So I will explain attachment of deltoid and function of deltoid. Let's look at origin of deltoid. Actually, deltoid is very wide muscle. So origin is very wide. You see this red tape? This red tape represents anterior fiber of deltoid. So anterior fiber attaches on clavicle, basically. And this beige tape, this is the middle fiber of deltoid. It attaches on acromion. Acromion is a part of scapula, which is this pointy part. This is acromion. So middle part attaches on acromion. And this blue tape is posterior fiber of deltoid, which attaches on spine of scapula. So anterior fiber attaches on clavicle. Middle fiber attaches on acromion. Posterior fiber attaches on spine of scapula. See, this is very wide muscle. Why do I differentiate deltoid? Because each fiber has different function. Let's look at insertion first. Insertion of deltoid is here. This part is called deltoid tuberosity. Origin of deltoid is very wide, like this. But insertion is very narrow. It's very pointy. So deltoid shapes like fan shape, like this. Very wide origin and very narrow insertion. Some people consider or some people separate deltoid muscle as six parts. You can divide very tiny piece for deltoid, but in this video I make three parts. So let's look at main functions of deltoid. Basically, main function of deltoid is abduction of shoulder. Abduction is when you open up shoulder this way. You raise up sideways, right? So basic function of deltoid is abduction. Anterior fiber does abduction, middle fiber does abduction, and posterior fiber does abduction. And middle fiber is the main, you know, abductor. What do anterior fibers and posterior fibers do rather than abduction? I will explain that. You know, anterior fiber is located on anterior part of shoulder joint, right? Because it's anterior fiber, it's on the anterior side. So if this muscle pulls shoulder this way, you know, because the direction of fiber is this way, if fiber pulls this way, what would this muscle do for shoulder joint other than abduction? It can do flexion. Flexion is you raise up this way, forward. Yeah, flexion, because this can pull this way. And also it can do internal rotation of shoulder joint. Imagine this fiber pulls shoulder this way, this diagonal direction. So this can do flexion and internal rotation. Of course, this can do abduction as well. So let's look at posterior fiber. If posterior fiber pulls shoulder joint this way, what would happen? It can extend shoulder joint. Extension is this way. You pull arm this way. And also external rotation. I think posterior fiber is very important for external rotation because there are not many external rotators of shoulder joint. Posterior fiber of deltoid, teres minor, and infraspinatus. Infraspinatus and teres minor are very weak muscle compared to deltoid, because these two muscles are part of rotator cuff muscles. Rotator cuff is not designed to exert strong power like deltoid or pectoralis minor or latissimus dorsi. this main function is stabilize shoulder joint. Then posterior fiber of deltoid can do external rotation. I think this part is the main power for external rotation. So deltoid is very wide muscle. I would like to talk about relationship with anterior fiber and pectoralis major, pec major. Pec major is very large muscle like deltoid located here. And you see this very close relationship with pec major and anterior fiber. We tend to divide muscle one by one, like, you know, pec major, deltoid. But in reality, there's not much obvious border in between two muscles unless you kind of dissect muscles. And the fascial connection, there's not obvious difference in between these two muscles. Yes, we named muscle pectoralis major, deltoid, but not obvious border here. So you can say anterior fiber and pectoralis major can do similar function. These two muscles can work together like this. Not obvious differentiation here. So I think this connection is very important in chest and front part of shoulder joint. Again, we tend to differentiate every single piece. Like, you know, I already divided three parts in deltoid today, and some people divide six parts. But if you see the body more broad way, we can observe that everything is connected. I only talked about pectoralis major and anterior fiber today, but if you look very broadly, you can notice there's much more connection through deltoid. So today I explained the anatomy of deltoid and function of deltoid. Then I explained a little bit about fascial connection with pectoralis major and deltoid. So if you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.